Hi, this is the first tutorial of a series on generating a service report on a work order. We have here a standard work order. It has of course some details. These details we want to get on our service report. It links to some, as a lookup to some fields like the contact here, the assets. We want to get all of this information of course into our service report. Next to that, it also has a bunch of child work order or work order line items and child work order line items and pictures. All of this information we want to get onto our service report. Step one, let's get at least the work order detail information onto our service report. I have a service report prepared. It's also part of our academy, so everybody can just download it. And what we're going to do is fill in these fields starting from our work order. Of course, we're not going to fill in all of these fields, but just show a couple of fields to get started. Let's go. So, what do we have? We have, of course, PDF Butler, the PDF Butler app. And in our PDF Butler app, we are generating a Service Report Academy. So this is the service report we are going to start, or the doc config we are going to start from. And we have a bunch of data sources. I have prepared all of the data sources already, because this is not a course on PDF Butler. This is a course on generating a service report. Everybody knows how to generate data sources via our Sockle Builder, and that's how I created the data source on the work order. So I use the Sockle Builder to select all of the fields I require, and I even went to the lookups, like for instance, get the account information, all of the account information that I need. Of course, these fields are all added already. So I added my filter to make sure I filter on here in the where class. I filter on the ID of the work order. I don't need all work orders. I just need this one that I'm starting from. And now I can start, of course, configuring my my docconfig. So next step, we go to our docconfig, and on the docconfig we open the document configuration page. So what I've already done is uploaded our document here. So it's just this this template document, and the next step is adding a data source. It's going to be of course the work order data source, and you see that there are a bunch of fields, so I'm going to use all of these fields, and I'm just going to now create config types. Let's fill in the account name. So account name, it's going to come from work order as a data source, and the field is going to be called account.name. So next up, let's fill in the date of today, so everybody sees that I'm really filling up information. This is not coming from the work order, because it's a record in Salesforce. It doesn't know the date of today. So what we're going to do is going to use the CatMiss constants, and just going to select now. Why not? Let PDF Butler format it for me. So I'm just going to select the long format and fill in today. Okay, let's maybe also use the account owner. Account owner, the data source is going to be work order again, of course, because that's where my data is coming from. And I just select the account owner name. So we see that we went from the work order to the account. We went from the account to the owner, and then selected the name of that owner, which is actually a user in Salesforce, of course. That's three. Let's go for six, maybe. Let's also fill in the work order number here. Oh, that's the wrong field. The wrong button, I mean. Work order. We fill in the work order number like this. Okay, and we fill in the work order subject. The subject. Okay, like this. save to server. Everything saves, everything is validated, so it seems that we are ready to generate our report. Of course, you've seen that I didn't fill in any of this information, which is, of course, yeah, more of the same. So it's all coming via lookups on the work order or on the work order directly. So everybody can, of course, please just fill in these fields. Now, the moment of truth. We generate the document. It just takes a second, as you can see, and the document is there. We have our account filled in, we have our date filled in, we have our account owner filled in, so all of that looks perfectly okay, and we have our work order number and the subject of the work order. So step one is done. We have created our work order service report and we have filled it with initial data. Now we go to step two. We actually get all of the pictures related to our work order and start filling those pictures right here at this position. Okay, cool. So this is it for step one.